We're broadcasting.
Yes.
All right. Greetings and salutations. I am Odyssey Fan, and welcome to the Odyssey Fan Museum, where my collection is in this room. Our purpose today is we just wanted to give a live tour, video record of the museum, of my collection, and the second part of that is we are attempting to set a Guinness World Record for the largest Adventures in the Odyssey collection in the world. We like to say attempt, even though we know it's the largest, but this is for the official record, so we just want to document everything as we go. So let's start off with some history. I started listening to Odyssey in 1987. Started recording episodes off the radio. I actually have a box here. We can come back out. I've still got all these cassette tapes that I recorded off the radio in the late 80s, early 90s. Original broadcast recordings. So then in 1992, the folks on Family and Adventures in Odyssey did the Secret Word Contest. And as part of that, I won these two albums, Album 7, Album 9, those very albums. And after that, I decided to start collecting all of the cassette albums and everything pretty much Odyssey-related. In 1994, folks on the family opened the Welcome Center down in Colorado Springs, not too far from here. So then I started collecting Wits End merchandise, memorabilia, T-shirts, hats, things like that. We'll show you all that in just a minute. In 1997, Clubhouse magazine started running their regular Odyssey feature called the Odyssey Scoop. So I started collecting the Clubhouse magazines, and I've got this box here full of Clubhouse magazines from the last 25 years. It's over 200 magazines that I've managed to get my hands on. I've also collected other magazines. I don't know if you can show the ones I put out here. Focus on the Family, Clubhouse Junior, Breakaway, they've all done different articles on Odyssey, so I've collected all of those over the years. Along with that, I've collected some other non-Odyssey items that actually contain Adventures in Odyssey items, and I'll go over those in just a minute. So let me do a quick walkthrough and show you what we've got here. I'm going to start off up here with this bookshelf, and we've got all of the original books here, the original Odyssey books here, first edition, second editions, and then we've got the passages books, all the different cover variations, the video adaptations, Kids Bureau, and the Imagination Station series of books there. And then down on this shelf, we've got the omnibooks, Kids Bureau, passages, omnibooks, the devotionals, and then we've got all the Adventures in Odyssey Bibles, the old hardbacks, the newer hardback, softback, and then we've got the official guides, some script books, and some other books, and I'll show you those. Show you a couple of those in detail in just a minute. Down below that, we've got all the cassette albums, starting with the Family Portraits, back 1987, the original Family Portraits album. Not very many people have these. These are very rare. And then we've got the Odyssey USA and the original Adventures in Odyssey album, and then on with album 2 on through the rest of the series. We've got the original colored clamshells, the gold audio series, and then the regular re-released white clamshells, a more commercial release, a more widely available release. Moving on over to this rack, we've got the CD albums. That was when they started with album 16, of course. They switched over to CDs. So I started collecting all the CD albums. Sorry, lost my place. And that includes all of the repacks, the variations, the multi-packs, things like that, all the different versions of each album. We've got special collections, we've got the individual CDs, we've got the individual cassettes, all the individual cassettes that came out from the 1991 Chick-fil-A release on through the 90s individual cassettes. Let's move on up to here. We've got the video, DVD, all of the original two-episode red case DVDs, and then all the repackaged, and then again repackaged with the new logo in 2010. Moving on down, we've got special collections that I like to put together here. We've got the educational videos, the American history from HSLDA, the collector's pack of the video games, the collector's pack of the Imagination Station books, the DVD collections, Novacom, Go West Young Men collector set, just some different collections there. Moving on down there, we've got some two cassette albums, the Amazing Stories cassette tapes, the VHS, the original VHS series, including the twin packs, the special collections. On down below that, some more rare items. We've got the videos in Spanish. We've got some things from the United Kingdom, some tapes, books. We've got a couple. I'll actually pull these out. We've got a couple of these videos from Singapore in foreign languages. And then down below that bottom shelf, we've got the puzzles and games that were released. So if we can zoom out and go up this wall, to show you, we've got some posters and autographed photos on this wall. We've got all the actors' photos from the 2012 live show up at the top, some various posters, not widely available, especially the Escape from the Forbidden Matrix poster, which was released to bookstores only, Christian bookstores. And then, of course, like I was saying earlier, up here we've got the Wits End Soda Shop t-shirt from the Welcome Center down in Colorado Springs. Is there, sorry, get ahead of myself. Is there any questions on the broadcast? Is anybody on there? Is there any questions at this point? Because then we're going to transition and flip around this way. Probably moving really fast there. Didn't know if we missed anything. So, well, let me go back to the top shelves and show you guys the water bottles. We've got, starting with the newest, the Blue Bling bottle, we like to call it. Just came out this year, 2014. The aluminum bottles in all six colors. And then some of the older water bottles still with the new logo. And then over on this shelf, we've got some of the older bottles as we go back to the 25th anniversary, 2012, the Silver Celebration water bottle, the 20th anniversary water bottle, and then we've got one of the older Wits End Soda Shop cups, the even older cups. And then the first water bottle that we're aware of, it says official memorabilia from Wits End. That was released in 1997 for the 1997 live show. All right, so showed you the autograph photos. If we move up into the corner, what we've got up in the corner is trading cards, one of the promotional items I'm going to talk about in just a minute. Trading cards are not sold. They're just given out as part of a promotion. We've got the original trading cards up on the right side of the corner from 2002, 2003. And then up on the left side of the corner, we've got the 20th anniversary trading cards. And then the uncut sheets of the latest trading cards from 2010. That were released in Clubhouse Magazine. However, these are uncut sheets with the printer's marks on the top that we got at the Get in the Show, November 2012. So one of the items that makes the collection unique, and that's one of the things I'm going to talk about over here, is we've got this, one of my favorite items, the uncut sheet of the 20th anniversary trading cards, believed to be the only one in existence. That was a gift from Nathan Hoobler. And on this table here, what we wanted to showcase was some of the promotional items that are also not sold in stores. You can't buy them from Christian book distributors, Folks on the Family, whatever. They were given away as promotions. One of the things that makes a collection unique is you can't just go to the store and buy something. And so a lot of these items, the bookmarks, the flyers, the hats, the balloons, the toys, the pins, different things are not available commercially, which is what makes them memorabilia and not merchandise. So that's a few things there that make our collection one of the largest, most unique. I do have the press kits. Again, not commercially available. A promotional item only given to certain people for certain events. Off here on this bookcase, let's go this way, we've got the hats starting at the top. Sorry. New cameraman. We've got the hats from various years, and they're all stacked up there, but there are detailed pictures on my Facebook page, of course. T-shirts, hats, calendars. The book bag right there is an actor promo, something that they gave to the actors in California. Of course, not all the actors kept them, so they wind up on eBay, which is how they wind up in my collection. I believe they made 40 of those. I think Evan told me that, but not very many of those. And if you transition left to the hoodie, you've got another actor promo. This is a hoodie that they only made and gave to the actors. All right, now if we can come back up to this shelf, again, some more unique, one-of-a-kind items. One of our favorites is our card here. It was given to us, me and my wife, by all of the Odyssey cast and crew at the Dallas Live Show. That was coordinated by Mrs. McCusker. It was very nice. All autographed, all signed by the cast and crew that were in Dallas. So that was a very special item, one of a kind. and then moving back to this side, you just get a wide view, that's fine. Again, we've got some bookstore items like the shelf caps. that were only given to bookstores. Another gift from Nathan Hoobler. Thank you. And then I did want to show you a few of those non-Odyssey items that we've got. And that would include the Awana set. So this is for Awana, but it does have Odyssey items in it, artwork, CDs with the episodes, that kind of thing. So that's a non-Odyssey item that contains Adventures in Odyssey material. Obviously, like I said, there's Faith Launch. And then over here, we've also got these VHS tapes, the Just for Kid tapes, that contained an Adventures in Odyssey episode. One of the unique non-Odyssey items. We've also got the Last Chance Detectives with Jason Whitaker in the story, things like that. Okay, so like I said, we are attempting a Guinness World Record for the largest collection in the world. We have collaborated with various other people in trying to document this. Right now, we have heard back from Guinness as far as the process goes. We've submitted an application. We've heard back from them, and they wanted an accurate count of how many unique individual items we had in our collection standpoint. And we counted up, and we came up with 1,150 as of today. We do have a few more items coming later this week. We have more stuff coming all the time. Obviously, new books coming out, new albums coming out, new merchandise coming out all the time. On that merchandise note, I did want to show this wall and this shelf, if you can get a high enough view of the shelf. These are some merchandise items from folks on the family in Colorado Springs. Bookmarks, dog tags, carabiners, pencils, pens, sunglasses, beach ball, magnets, postcards, things like that. Some of the stuff available on Christian Book Distributor, some of it only available in Colorado Springs. Some of our more unique items, again, the volunteer badges. We worked at the live shows in 2012. Any questions? I know we did want to mention some of the other collectors, like my friend Paul Brown. He's been collecting for quite some time, several rare, unique items. We last estimate his collection about 150 items. Very impressive. Austin and Tasha, we didn't want to mention Austin and Tasha, the AIO blogcast. Thanks for helping us promote our event today. And also Brent with the Wits End podcast. He's been getting into collecting. Hopefully, some of my influence. we've been trying to help him out with that. We do have a couple of unique items we might be able to give him that I found recently going through stuff. And, of course, the Odyssey Scoop and Jacob. He's been doing the Scoop Yourself contest for the last 4 years, maybe five. And we use that as a reference point for guessing that most other collections are nowhere near the size of ours. So I want to thank Jacob for his work there. And then, of course, we also use the merchandise section on his website, as well as the AIO HQ, which I used to work on with Nathan Hoobler, and the AIO Wiki, and I believe that's Mark, that works on the AIO Wiki for their merchandise section. We do have a question. My favorite item? Oh, my favorite item. Oh, that's tough. There's so many. I did mention the wedding card. That's right up there. I do have some autographs from several actors that are no longer with us. Paul Herlinger, Walker Edmiston, Dave Madden. If you look up here, there's cast photos there. No autographs there. I've got them in my complete guide, but those are very special. Those actors have passed on now. I do have a lot of these framed autographs that are personalized. Arias, Katie's down on the bottom shelf. Sorry, I'm throwing you all over the place. I've got Earl Bone, of course, that played Dr. Regis Blackard and his twin brother. I've got the Eugene action figure that's autographed by Will Ryan. So a lot of special items. I think I will have to say that the most special is the wedding card by the cast and crew that was given to me and my wife. That was very special. I know one of the questions was from Odyssey Lover, and she asked about the autographs. And I guess we've got time. I can show you a couple other autographs that I've got in here. If you want to zoom in, Mike. So this is from my complete guide. And this I didn't buy in the store. I bought this from Phil Lawler. And he actually spelled my name wrong, but he fixed it when I met him at the 1997 live show. So I've got some interesting and unique autographs in here. It flips through to Marshall Younger, Mark Drury, Phil Lawler again, Paul McCusker, Chuck Balty, Dave Arnold, and furthermore, Dave Arnold again, Alyssa Hall Johnson, Paul Herlinger, passed away, Townsend Coleman, Katie Lee, Dave Madden, again passed away recently, Chris Anthony. So, I do have some more autographs in my new official guide, or I guess if you want to call it the second edition official guide. And I know Bren had a question about the cups. I hope we showed those enough. We have another question? Go ahead. Oh, the Odyssey Times newspapers. Yeah, let's zoom over here. I do have two up on the wall. I do have four editions. I believe there were six editions released. And you can actually download full-res PDFs from the Odyssey Scoop. I helped Jacob scan in one of those. Those were given out at Focus on the Family in the mid-90s before they started doing them online. Get you close. So like I said, if you want to read the insides of those, they have them online. I believe I have one duplicate, so I have technically five, although I think I have two of the issue number five. Pretty rare. I don't know how many of those they made, but I've only seen a couple here and there because they only gave them out at Focus on the Family. So again, that's a promotional item, not merchandise. Next question.
Is there something that you own that is the only one in existence, not including the wedding card?
I believe I did mention the uncut sheet of trading cards. I don't know if you noticed there are printer's marks at the bottom. It is double-sided. The other one was only one-sided. It only had the front faces. We do believe that is the only one in existence. That's what Nathan told me when he gave it to me. So, yes, a one-of-a-kind item. There are other one-of-a-kind items in existence that I don't own. There was an Adventures in Odyssey watch made for one of the contests in 2003. Some girl named Bethany, I think, won that watch. I was a little jealous, you know. there were some puzzles, things like that that I still don't own. But as far as one-of-a-kind items, the trading cards, and then obviously autographs, if they're personalized, given to me. I know my wife has a script that was autographed by Katie Lee up on the wall here, if you want to zoom in on that. That was at the Taylor University event that Katie spoke at. My wife got to go to the after party, I guess, with the other Odyssey fans and Katie Lee. So that's a unique, one-of-a-kind item, if that answers your question. Next question.
What's with the certificate? If you already talked about it, I'm sorry.
Okay, so let's come back over here. I do have a couple things like that. I've got the official charter member certificate from the OAC. I think you're talking about the one up here. This was from the original witsend.org. You're too close. Sorry. This was the original witsend.org clubhouse that they had on there. You had to join, and they had a monthly email or whatever that you had to read and follow. And if you did 12 of those in a row, you got a certificate, you know, signed by Wit, so to speak, that you could print out from the club. I hope that answers your question. I just found that yesterday. That's why it just got framed and put up. I can post a picture of it later on my Facebook page if you want to see that in detail. I might have a PDF. Any other questions? Okay.
Do you own the Adventures in Odyssey sticker set?
The sticker set, yes, I do. Hang right there, Mike. I will pull out a couple things here that I can show you. So, I do have the sticker set. It's still unopened. It's got a sticker book, some various stickers. Pretty rare. It's from the mid-90s. That has a price tag of $6.95 on it. I have seen them occasionally on eBay, but not lately. I do have the scrapbook, the second edition of the scrapbook. I do have the stationery pack, some paper and things there. The peel and play activity set. I think that opens. Has some peel off stickers that you can put in the playset, make your own scene, yada yada. And then, of course, the first edition of the scrapbook, still sealed. So those are in line with that sticker set, some of the rare 1990s collectibles. Next question.
I seem to recall that there were Odyssey pogs made at some point. Do you have them?
Yes, I do. If you look right up here, we went by it a couple times. This is the pog set. I also have another unopened set of pogs, still shrink wrapped. I'm kind of that way. But that's still in the sheet, but it was opened. That was the first one I obtained. The second one is still sealed and shrink wrapped, folded over on itself. But yes, there were pogs as part of the Go West Young Man video. They made the pogs, the trading cards, various other collectibles just for that video, just different promotional items. Next question. Is that it? Okay. Where are we at on time?
5:40.
Okay.
The timer is on.
29 minutes.
Okay. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I could showcase here. Anything I missed? No. So hopefully we'll have an announcement about the Guinness World Records coming up soon. Yeah. That's my collection. So maybe we'll do another one of these sometime. Show off some new stuff always on my Facebook page. So you can follow me on there, on Google+, Twitter. And you can ask me questions anytime on any of those sites. So we're going to wrap this up. And yeah. Goodbye.